Hi everyone, I'm Ian.
Hi, I'm Yichen.
Today we're here to talk to you about the seventh principle of green chemistry, which is the use of renewable feedstocks. This principle states that a feedstock or raw material should be renewable rather than depletable whenever technically or economically practicable.
A raw material is similar to an ingredient. It is a basic substance in starting or semi-process state and not yet the final product. So if we consider cookie as an example of the final product, then one of its feedstocks will be sugar.
As another example, we could also consider sugar as a final product. Plants make sugar via photosynthesis, and one of the feedstocks they use is CO2, or carbon dioxide.
When we talk about no materials or feedstocks being renewable, we mean that they can be replenished on a human time scale. Many common feedstocks cannot be replenished this quickly, such as coal, natural gas, oil, and minerals. All of these finite resources are being used up by human activities, and it would take many thousands or even millions of years to replenish.
On the other hand, an example of a renewable feedstock is biomass, meaning any material derived from a living organism, usually plants. When biomass is used as a feedstock, new plants can be grown relatively quickly to replenish that resource. In other words, the feedstock is renewable on a human timescale.
Now that we know the meaning of renewable feedstocks, let's consider why it is important to use these whenever possible, instead of feedstocks from depleting resources. Basically, the end goal is to have a steady and a continuous supply of the resources for the future.
Take crude oil, for example, which is a feedstock for many products. Oil is formed underground through very, very slow natural processes. We simply can't wait millions of years for new oil deposits to form. It is easier to plant and harvest biomass than to wait that long. So how does this apply to chemistry in a lab?
Well, the type of feedstocks can also be considered when we choose the components in a reaction, such as reagents and solvents. We already made a video explaining the importance of solvent choice, but today let's look at two solvents as example of renewable feedstocks.
A popular ether solvent used in chemistry labs is tetrahydrofuran, or THF for short. However, the synthesis of THF industrially is made from fossil fuels, which are not renewable.
An alternative to THF is 2-methyl tetrahydrofuran, or 2-methyl THF, which has very similar structure to THF and has very similar properties as the ether solvent. But 2-methyl THF has the benefit of being synthesized from biomass, which is a renewable resource.
Many reactions might specify an ether solvent, but we can carefully choose which ether solvent to implement a little bit of green chemistry every day. The substitution of THF for 2-methyl THF in our reactions is just one way in which we can put Principle 7 into action. Another way this principle is being used is through interdisciplinary research to find more uses for biomass-derived compounds, giving us more options to use renewable resources rather than depleting ones.
Thank you for watching this video. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to view the rest of our series on the principles of green chemistry. If you want to learn more about the Green Chemistry Initiative, check us out at our website, Facebook or Twitter.